They were having their evening meal a little after 6 o'clock, with Peter sitting on one side of Thomas and Nathaniel on the other, when the doubting apostle said, "I will not believe unless I see the Master with my own eyes, and put my finger in the mark of the nails." As they thus sat at supper, and while the doors were securely shut and barred, the morontia master suddenly appeared inside the curvature of the table, and standing directly in front of Thomas, said, "Peace be upon you. For a full week have I tarried, that I might appear again when you were all present, to hear once more the commission to go into all the world and preach this gospel of the kingdom. Your mission to the world is founded on the fact that I lived a God-revealing life among you, on the truth that you and all other men are the sons of God." When the master had so spoken, he looked down into the face of Thomas and said, "And you, Thomas, who said you would not believe unless you could see me and put your finger in the nail marks of my hands, have now beheld me and heard my words. And though you see no nail marks on my hands, since I am raised in the form that you also shall have when you depart from this world, what will you say to your brethren?" "You will acknowledge the truth, for already in your heart you have begun to believe, even when you so stoutly asserted your unbelief. Your doubts, Thomas, always most stubbornly assert themselves, just as they are about to crumble. Thomas, I bid you not be faithless, but believing, and I know you will believe, even with the whole heart." When Thomas heard these words, he fell on his knees before the morontia master and exclaimed, "I believe, my Lord and my Master." Then said Jesus to Thomas, "You have believed, Thomas, because you have really seen and heard me. Blessed are those in the ages to come who will believe even though they have not seen with the eye of flesh, nor heard with the mortal ear." The Urantia Book, paper 191, section 5, paragraph 2.